Darcell Grimes hit the air at WLOS the same month and year MTV debuted. During that spin, she's delivered the news beside 11 co-anchors.
Good evening, I'm Hoyt Harris.
Hoyt Harris was number one.
She was the adult in the room, and I'm sure I was the child. Even though I'm considerably older than her, she was the mother, and I was probably the incorrigible child.
You were just a prankster.
The restoration crew at the Biltmore Estate.
Ken Owen says in the late 80s, he learned a lot about news and life next to Darcell.
When we all get in this business, we hope that we somehow are able to leave a mark on our community and enhance the work that's done in journalism. And Darcell checked both of those boxes in a big way.
In the early 90s, Mark Pompilio learned co-anchoring with a legend is about as good as it gets.
When you've had enough co-anchors, you really relish the ones where it was easy.
I can tell you that's true. That's true. And I think what helped with us was, you know, I knew you as a reporter and we had worked together. And so we knew each other and we were friends. And that makes it a lot easier.
Now, one big item on the agenda.
In the late 90s, Frank Crocker says working with Darcell was a dream.
We had different levels of energy. And I think the two levels of energy really suited each other and made the partnership that you need to have.
Larry Blunt co-anchored for some 12 years with her, so he can tell you Darcell is the real deal.
A lot of anchors around the country, they act at anchoring. You're very real. You're very genuine. I used to tell people all the time, I said, what you see on the air, that's her.
Hard to believe she's technically anchored in five different decades, but folks knew they could trust and admire her a long time ago.
The viewers knew right off the bat that she was a very professional, young anchorwoman, but with a lot of potential.